Hello, Walking Dead fans. This is JAR369, and welcome back for another horror toy review for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days. I'll be taking a look at the Walking Dead McFarlane Toys Negan figure made by McFarlane Toys. Take a look at the packaging. You can see this is a Walking Dead smaller carded packaging. You can see the window exposing the figure and all his accessories. Exclusive figure, I'm assuming Walgreens, what, right? I don't know. You see the window of Negan right here on the back. There's other figures like the 5-inch characters. You get Aaron, Sasha, and Rick. And there's other characters in the color top 7-inch figures who are originally statues like Michonne, Rick, Abraham, and Daryl. And also a 10-inch Glenn figure. So that's about it for the packaging. Let's take out Negan out of the package. Here is Negan out of the package. Let's take a closer look at the figure. Take a closer look at the head sculpt. Well, for the likeness to Jeffrey Dean Morgan, say it's a not too bad of a job with his head sculpt. Yeah, McFarlane is, yeah, back then McFarlane Toys head sculpt, it's really okay. It's still not too bad. You can see his beard and his stylized hair and everything. Oh, on the show, I mean, look at his beard. He does have like some white on his beard, but well, his hair is not too white, like a little bit black and white, that's all. Anyway, let's take a look at his outfit here. You can see he is wearing his scarf around his neck right there. Yeah, you can clearly see his skin neck right there. And you get the his Von Z jacket here. With some zippers sculpted in there and some buttons as well. And take a look at the hands. You can see there's one hand for like... for holding his bat Lucille. The other hand is the same thing, gripping hand. And you can see some wrinkles all over the jacket. There's like a little zipper lines there on each sleeves. You can see there's like a belt buckle right there and some silver paintings on there and some holes there on the belts. And you can see like a little bit sculpted on the fly there. And there's some little bit pockets sculpted in there. Nothing much on the back, but you can see there's like a little sculpted on his back pockets. And take a look at the boots. Just the generic biker boots. You can see there's some buckle painted on, some buckle printed, some buckle sculpted in the painted on silver. And yikes, there's a silver painting right there. And on the bottom, there are some legalese and two pickles in the bottom of his feet there. But overall, for the figure itself, it's a really not too bad looking figure, I would say. The head sculpt could have been a little bit better, but hey, it's the old McFarlane Toys. Articulation, there's the... well, the head does not go fully rotate because it's a little bit stuck. There's like... also does not go all the way because it's hindered by this scarf. Arms do go fully rotate. Does go in and out. Bend at the elbows, rotate. There's like the lower wrist rotate and hinge. Upper wrist there too. It looks like it doesn't have any waist articulation, but the legs kick forward, back, in and out. Bend at the knees, rotate. Boot rotation, and that's about it. So yeah, very poseable, standard 5-inch McFarlane articulation, but you can still give him some poseabilities on this guy. Accessories. Sorry, I'm trying to fix his arm. And look, still no waist articulation because I really want to make his whole body straight because it looks weird. He does come with his bat Lucille, was, you can see some silver painting on the barbed wire there. You can actually put the Lucille on his hand like so. And yeah, the little stamp is a bit thin, so be careful if you want to put on his hand. Because you don't want to end up breaking it. There you go. There he is. You have him like do like this, like see which victim will have their heads bashed. Like so. But if you take off this hand here, he does come with the straight hand here that you can actually put on. And let me do this off camera. Do do do. Do, do, do. Ah, there we go. Let's try to take off the bad hand there. Finally. And then put the hand on. There we go, much better. Now you have Negan holding the bat like that, but he doesn't put it all the way to the shoulder. I really wish he does. Come on, McFarlane in the past. You could just give him like a double jointed elbows and make him like this. Wow, disgraceful. But anyway, still really a not too bad figure. Overall, for the figure itself, it's really not bad. The head sculpt could have been a lot better. Articulation standard. McFarlane Toys articulation with their 5-inch figures. But you can still give them some crazy action posibilities. Accessory, I really like he came with Lucille. And the interchangeable, and just a usual interchangeable hand. But still a really a not too bad looking figure, I would say. I'm not sure if this figure, you can find this figure anywhere else for a reasonable price because, well, it's Negan. Negan is a popular character in the Walking Dead universe, I think. But if you already have this figure, the 5-inch version of Negan, what do you think? Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. And I know there's a 7-inch version of Negan where he's fully articulated, but I don't have that, so yeah. If I search it online, like eBay, probably costs a lot of money. But I'm okay with this figure. For my rate, I'm going to give the McFarlane Toys Walking Dead Negan figure a... I'll give it like an 8 out of 10. I hope you enjoyed my review. If you did, please consider like, comment, share, and subscribe if you're new to my channel. And follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Both links will be in the description down below. That's all I have to say. This is the McFarlane Toys, The Walking Dead Negan, made by McFarlane Toys. And this is JAR369. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you for the next horror toy review for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days. And remember, stay spooky, my friends.